A very good morning to all of you. I'm very happy to be here today. This is not the first time I'm coming to this college. I had come for another Department of Education's program, but this is my first interaction, I think, with the students as such. I congratulate the luminaries who are passing out with medals, but I also compliment and congratulate each one of you who have been able to complete your course. It was around, I think, 5-6 years ago when I was passing out of my college. And believe me, that was one of the happiest days of my life, because I thought, holy shit, the books are over. I am done with these books. I had a job, I had a placement, so I was feeling very happy. I thought, enough, I'll never go back to books again. Enough of studies, finally I am done. I have a job, I am an independent person, and I don't need anyone again. Well, what I realize now is, at least college life was much better. You had a syllabus, you had a portion, and you had a fixed group of students among which you had to compete. Life was very sorted in college. With a few syllabus, a few students to compete, you knew who are your competitors, who can edge you out, how can you complete your course, what are the questions, which faculty will set what type of questions, and your life was sorted. After college, I got into Larsen & Toubro as a job placement, and there was no syllabus. The competition was the entire employees of the company, though a small company throughout India. The work was never defined. This may not be the story of just one company. That is how all the jobs are. The work is never defined. The job suddenly comes to you. You have to do this within a particular period of time. And then I felt a little monotonous and all. So I thought, okay, what else can I do? Then I thought, okay, UPSC looks good, big vehicle, a little respect you get. And as I thought, okay, at least I'll be in a commanding position. In Larsen & Toubro, I was the one who was getting commands all the time from my manager. So I thought, good, this is a better job. At least I get to command. So I said, okay, UPSC. I got into UPSC. But believe me now, the work is endless. I have no idea from where the work will come to me suddenly. Some law and order issues, some phone from secretariat, and I have work. So I plan my weekend, and then suddenly work comes. And competition, there is no competition at all now. Because you yourself become your competition. Madam, in that meeting you said that. You haven't done that still. So what I'm trying to say is, up to now, your life was sorted. Now, my dear friends, welcome to the world of chaos. Welcome to the world of a journey. As long as you keep learning and improving your personality by each day, by experiences and mistakes, and learning from that mistakes, and as long as you continue to grow, you will be able to have a respectful survival in the world. The day you stop learning, the day you stop growing, you will be eliminated, because a lot of competition is there, not just in the job, in whatever profile you go. So my best wishes for this great journey that you're about to start. At the same time, since you all have just passed out, what was the purpose of your education? When I started my graduation, it was just getting a job. A good job, a good package was my purpose for education. But gradually I realized the purpose for my education, that is what has happened to most of India. There has been a goal displacement. We all are studying to get a job because society wants us to get a job. Our parents want us to get a job. Our neighbors want us to get a job. We want to show off in front of our cousins that we have a job. But is job the only purpose of our education? A little reflection would show we have millions of engineers, we have millions of doctors, but how many scientists have we been able to actually produce? Besides Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, do we have another scientist of national repute for the last 40, 50 years? No. We had an era of Jagdish Chandra Bose and Ramanujam, but why not in the last 40 years? How many social thinkers have India been able to produce? Besides Amartya Sen, do we have another economist of national world repute? The reason being, for the last 40, 50 years, we have grown immensely in our labs. We have world-class labs, we have world-class college, we have autonomous institutions, deemed universities. But the purpose of education has become to get a job. And there, my dear friends, once you get a job, try and use your studies to find solutions for the problems of society as well. If you are a student of sociology or maybe social sciences, just try to look around you. There are so many problems in the society. How will you come to a solution towards that? If you are a science student, try to apply the science towards solving the problems of society. One example that I will give you is Kerala, unlike the rest of India, is an aging society. We are not a population which is under the age of 30, unlike the rest of India. So one problem which Kerala is immensely facing as of now is we have big houses. The children, the offsprings are working in the Gulf, and the old age people are living all alone by themselves in those big houses. So isn't it a social problem for Kerala? How do we solve it? Government does not have the resources to reach out to every house. You people have to come up with solutions. Try to form volunteer groups. Spend one Sunday, 1 hour every week with elders in your locality. Try to shoulder the responsibility of elders as a community now. There are so many small issues that are growing. Another example I would give you is solid waste management. We all keep complaining that municipality is not picking up waste. When I talk to the municipality says, "Madam, we clean it with our own trailers and we clean it ourselves, but next third, fourth day again the place is full of waste. How long will we keep cleaning?" What is needed is actually communities have to come up to shoulder the need and the shoulder the problems and find solution to those problems. Be it solid waste management, be it the aging issue, whatever. So it's high time now, once you have a job, spend time in voluntary activities. Volunteerism is not something which should come out only when in the wake of a disaster. If we have Kerala floods, we are volunteering and coming together to do relief work. No, volunteerism has to become a day-to-day activity, and that has to be done by you. You need to use your education, science, social studies, whatever you have studied, and find real-time, form community groups and find real-time solutions to the problems that society is facing. Community participation and citizens' participation can only be the solution to all maladies in the society today. Best wishes to all of you. May all make the maximum out of your potentials. Thank you.